members, you may be seated. Good morning and welcome to the Carlisle High School National Honor Society Induction Ceremony. Thank you for taking the time to join us today. The National Honor Society is a service organization that believes the leaders of the school are obligated to use their strengths to serve the school and community. Today's inductees exemplify what the school and community look for in our students. These students have been chosen for their excellence in four major areas: scholarship, service, leadership, and character. Hopefully, the National Honor Society's influence will encourage the entire student body to work harder in these areas to improve our school and community. I would like to introduce our high school principal, Mr. Huber, who would like to say a few words with our members.
Thank you, Derek. And welcome to everybody here today as we celebrate the induction of our new National Honor Society members. Congratulations to the 34 newest members. There are four pillars that students must demonstrate superior traits in: scholarship, character, leadership, and service. These intangible skills are not instilled in a couple weeks or even a couple months. These skills are instilled in an upbringing and are a direct reflection of the amazing support and guidance from the home environment. So mom, dad, grandma, grandpa, that comes from you. This moment is possible because of your hard work. Students, be sure to share your thanks with those who have supported you along your journey. The two pillars that I'd like to take a brief moment to elaborate on are leadership and service, or combined the two together for servant leadership. Service is helping others, providing value, bettering the system. Leadership is the art of motivating people to act towards a common goal. Supporting others is an amazing experience for all involved. In almost every situation, the individual providing the service walks away feeling as if they were the one who gained. As all of our high school students continue their high school journey, I would encourage all of our students to continue to think and challenge about how you're helping others and how you're leading other students to help other students. Build your capacity and increase your impact for good. I have no doubt that all of our National Honor Society students and members are on a great path that will lead to personal success and happiness. Most importantly, happiness. Once again, I want to welcome everybody here and provide a congratulations to our 34 newest members to the National Honor Society. Thank you.
Now allow me to explain the admissions process for becoming a member into the National Honor Society. After the first semester of the school year, sophomores, juniors, and seniors who qualified received notification that they were eligible to apply. Applications were handed out, and for those who chose to, returned them with the required information. The Carlisle High School Faculty Council reviewed the applications, and after much discussion, the inductees were chosen. Current members: Grant Cheney, Michael Coelho, Alyssa Nacero, Colton Powers, Haley Saylor, and Reese Smith will introduce this year's inductees. Please hold all applause until the end. Thank you.
Kara Atkins. Kara is a member of the soccer and softball teams and a PBIS leader. Ashley Allen. Ashlyn is a member of the basketball and softball teams and has volunteered to buy gifts for the less fortunate. Cruz Allison. Cruz is a member of the football, basketball, and track teams and is also active in performing arts. Elise Banks. Elise is a member of the soccer and softball teams. She is also active in her church. Wyatt Benton. Wyatt is a member of the basketball and track team and is active in the performing arts. Kirsten Bottles. Kirsten is a member of the softball and tennis team and is also active in her church.
Kerrigan Bowman. Kerrigan is a member of the softball team and also plays club softball. Bryce Brown. Bryce is a member of the football, wrestling, and track teams. Savannah Brown is a member of the softball team and also plays select softball. Kaylin Brown. Kaylin is active in performing arts, is class president, and is a member of the soccer team. Abigail Campbell. Abigail is a member of the band and is active in her church. Ava Carpenter. Ava is a member of the band, plays select soccer, and is active in her church.
Anna Gross. Anna is a member of the band and student council and has volunteered at Robin's Nest. Andrea Jackson. Andrea is an ensemble leader in the marching band. Aiden Johns. Aiden is a member of the tennis and golf teams and is active in his church. Olivia Jones. Olivia is a member of the track and soccer teams. Layla Knapp. Layla is a member of the basketball and softball teams and has volunteered with the Salvation Army. Titus Kramer. Titus is a member of the tennis team and the band.
Samantha Lambert. Samantha is a member of the track team, student council, and is the treasurer for her 4-H group. Kira Lewis. Kira is a member of the volleyball team and marching band and volunteers at Carlisle Manor. Greta Moore. Greta is a member of the tennis and cross country teams and is active in performing arts. She is also a student council member. Emma Motley. Emma is a member of the swim team and has volunteered at the library. Caden Neely. Caden is a member of the football and wrestling team and volunteers with Miracle League Baseball.
Chloe Lucas. Chloe is a member of the cross country team and is active in her church. Courtney Osborne. Courtney is a section leader in the Winter Winds and is active in 4-H. Caitlin Ragar. Caitlin is active in gymnastics and is a reading tutor. Tanner Riley. Tanner is a member of the football and baseball teams. Bradley Roy. Bradley is a member of the golf, wrestling, and baseball teams. Riley Sauerbeck. Riley is a member of the volleyball team and volunteers at Grace Greyhound Adoptions.
Raiden Shotwell. Raiden is a member of Student Council and has volunteered with Girl Scouts. Christopher Talbert. Christopher is a senior patrol leader of the Scouts of America and has volunteered at Camp Chautauqua. Liliana Tucker. Liliana is active in equestrian and has volunteered at Wildwind Equestrian Center. Madison Tusty. Madison is a cheerleader and has volunteered at many cheer camps. Alexia Wells. Alexia is a member of the Girl Scouts cross country and golf teams and is active in the performing arts.
Thank you, guys. You may be seated. It's now my pleasure to introduce our keynote speaker. After graduating from Carlisle High School as valedictorian in 1995, he attended Penn State University, where he's a member of the tennis team. After playing tennis professionally, he attended medical school at Wright State University before entering a residency in orthopedic surgery at The Ohio State University. After his residency, he accepted a fellowship at the Cleveland Clinic, working with various college and professional sports teams. He currently works as an orthopedic surgeon at Atrium Medical Center in Middletown and serves as a clinical professor at Wright State University. Please join me in welcoming Carlisle National Honor Society alumnus, Dr. Michael Greaser.
Thank you. Pleasure to be here this morning. I appreciate the invite. First of all, congratulations to everyone here. You, your families, your teachers, your mentors should be very proud of this accomplishment. This is a recognition of your values and beliefs and what you've worked hard in. The National Honor Society recognizes students for their academic and service accomplishments, but it also pushes the students to continue to develop through community and school engagement. And I was looking the other night at a list of National Honor Society members, and it's pretty unbelievable. There are professional athletes, actors, authors, Tony Award winners, senators, astronauts, Miss Americas, three of them, journalists, news anchors, judges, and war heroes. The list goes on and on. It's really unbelievable, and it's incredible that you guys get to become a part of it today. I think that's really cool. And then there's the rest of us, regular people. I'm Mike Greaser. I graduated from Carlisle in 95. My sister graduated in 1997. And I sat here in a room just like all of you guys 28 years ago. Sat right here in this, well, it wasn't right here in this room because Carlisle got all fancy and built a whole new freaking school. But it was a room just like this. Not really like this. It was smaller and dirtier, and it had a smell to it. But this room is pretty incredible. This whole new school is incredible, something to really be proud of. This, for me, was a moment that I was very proud of. It was the first time an organization had sort of recognized myself and my peers and said, we're very proud of what you mean to our school. We're very proud of what you mean to our community. And we want you to continue to uphold the things that make us proud of you. And I wanted to do that. And I remember that moment from 28 years ago like it was yesterday. It was very meaningful. When we talk about the National Honor Society, a couple of the speakers have alluded to the four pillars that they talk about. The first pillar they talk about is character. Character is defined as the force within an individual which distinguishes that person from others. When I think of character, I think of what is it that defines you as a person? How do others define you as a person? And do those two things match up? There are a lot of instances in life where people will misinterpret you and your values, sometimes for the better, sometimes for the worse. But I think the key part of character is maintaining yourself and your values and staying true to the things that you believe in. I think the other important part of character is that your values and your beliefs are basically good. Are you helping others? Do you have good intentions and good follow-through? Do you do what you tell people you're going to do? Are you doing the right things when no one is watching? Those are the things I think of when I think of character. The second pillar they discuss is service. Service is defined as the willingness to work without monetary compensation or recognition. I think of service as charity, volunteerism, helping others in a time of need. And I think the most important part, once again, is that you don't do these things for recognition or compensation. You do them because they're the right things to do. I think of service in two forms, individual service and organizational service. When I think of organizational service, I think about, did you organize a community blood draw? Do you contribute to local charities with your time and your money and your effort? I think of individual service as, did you help the old lady carry her groceries to the cart? Did you pay for the guy behind you in Chipotle when you noticed that he forgot his wallet? You know, little things like that that can impact an individual on a level that you may not realize. I think of those things as service. The third pillar is leadership. Leadership is defined as the willingness to yield one's own personal interests for the interests of others. And sometimes leadership is as simple as setting a good example. Sometimes leadership is very complicated and involves doing things that may not be in your best interest, but are in the best interest of your team, your community, your business, or your family. The interesting part about leadership to me is that sometimes leadership is getting out of the way of others who are more prepared or more equipped to do the things that need to get done. And so leadership really is not about being the boss. It's about knowing when you should be the boss and when you shouldn't, and getting in line so that things can get done appropriately. The fourth pillar in National Honor Society is scholarship. They define that as a commitment to learning. I think of it as a commitment to lifelong learning. There's no better example than in my profession. Actually, as an orthopedic surgeon, I have to update my knowledge constantly, almost every day, so that our patients can get the best care and the most modern care. I read for surgical cases every day. I read for cases this morning that are happening this afternoon. I read for my patients every day and every night. Drives my family crazy, but I do it. I just took an exam last week that I had to pass in order to continue doing what I do professionally, and I have to do that multiple times a year. And so it truly is a commitment to lifelong learning. But learning also comes in other forms. I think learning has to do with learning about yourself, learning about the people that surround and support you, and knowing them, knowing yourself and knowing others on a level beyond what they expect you to. And that takes a concerted effort. You have to really try to learn those things, and it's important to the people that are around you. I also think of learning or scholarship as a commitment to the future. In my case, I think, am I raising my kids in a house that supports and encourages lifelong learning, a house that values education and understanding? I also think about passing on knowledge. I work with residents and medical students every day, and I spend most of the day trying to show them or tell them the things that I've accumulated through experience, and hoping that that next generation of physicians will be able to pick up those tidbits, and maybe it helps them in the future to help others. In conclusion, what I really want to say, the take-home point of this rambling, is that Carlisle is a fantastic place. I loved growing up here. I valued everything I got from Carlisle. It's a fantastic education, whether you guys realize it or not. When I was growing up here, I remember sort of thinking, I don't know if this small town and this small school are really preparing me for the big world we're about to head out into and all the smart people I see. But the truth is, I remember getting to Penn State my freshman year, and about a month into classes, I remember thinking, geez, not only am I prepared, I'm way ahead of the curve. And I credit that to Carlisle and Carlisle High School. I remember sort of looking around in classes and going, geez, they didn't learn this stuff in high school? And I was thankful for that. It made my transition into the next step in life easier, less stressful, and more successful. And I think that translates whether you're talking about college or a career after high school. So have faith. Enjoy your family. Enjoy your community. Enjoy your small town. Be proud of where you came from. It's the one thing that people will ask you about the rest of your life. And it's way more fun to tell them about your small town surrounded by railroad tracks, where you hung out at the whistle stop after school. At least we did. I don't know about today's generation. And we have alien spaceships in some dude's yard. People love that. And when you tell them, they're going to look at you like you're crazy, but the one thing you're going to notice is that they're interested and they want to know more about you and they want to learn about your town and where you came from. And that's really the cool part about coming from a place like Carlisle. Understand that this small place has over-prepared you for the world that surrounds you, that you're headed into eventually. Finally, congratulations to all the students here. Congratulations to the parents, the teachers, the mentors. You've supported them and guided their values and decisions, and that's what we're here to celebrate today. God bless. I appreciate the opportunity to celebrate with you today. Thank you.
The candle I have just lit is the eternal candle of knowledge. It is eternal because knowledge never ends. Knowledge is gained through observation and experience. Knowledge is the fundamental factor that determines the path of a person's life. Knowledge not only facts, but also of self, of others, and of right and wrong. The four mentioned attributes, scholarship, service, leadership, and character, all originated from knowledge. Without knowledge, these characteristics would be non-existent. The National Honor Society believes we, as people, should constantly strive to increase our knowledge and use it to the best of our ability. Since all four characteristics drew their strengths from knowledge, there will be a speaker representing each of the four characteristics. They will light a candle symbolizing that characteristic and then speak on the topic. First is Alexa Moss speaking about scholarship.
Scholarship means a commitment to learning. A scholar is willing to spend hours reading and studying, knowing the lasting benefits of a cultivated mind. Everyone should continue to learn even when formal education has ended. Learning is a great element of life. It can be acquired only through diligence and effort. It furnishes the lamp by which we study and the light which illuminates the future. Learning makes us practical as it adds to our understanding of human needs. Candidates have the responsibility to expand their knowledge through opportunities inherent in scholarship. Next is Riley Cottrell speaking about service.
Service can be described in various ways. In the routine of a day's work, many opportunities arise to help others. Willingness to work for the benefit of those in need without monetary compensation or without regard or without recognition is the quality of service. We as National Honor Society members are committed to the idea of volunteering our time and abilities to the creation of a better tomorrow. Life is more fulfilling when the interests of others are served. Much has been given to us and much will be expected from us wherever there is a need. Service helps an individual obtain a stronger inner conscience and allows the lives of everyone to benefit. Next will be Emily Osra speaking on leadership.
Leadership should exert a wholesome influence on the school. In taking the initiative in class and school activities, the real leader strives to train, aid, motivate, and encourage others to obtain the same objective. The price of leadership is self-sacrifice, the willingness to yield one's personal objectives for the interest of others. As a leader has self-confidence and will stride forward while others hesitate. Every group is ineffectual without the guidance of a leader. We are challenged today, as never before, to find leaders who combine charisma with wisdom and right judgment. To those who are gifted with the capacity to lead, use your talents wisely. Leadership is always needed, thus to lead is an essential requirement of both our candidates and members. Next is Caroline Meehan with character.
Character is the force within each individual which distinguishes that person from others, giving them individuality. Character is a quality without which one cannot hope to attain respect from others. It is the force of character which guides one through life and over time becomes very important. Character is not received, it is achieved. It is the product of constant actions and striving daily to make the right choices. Self-control is one measurement of character. By demonstrating qualities such as reliability, honesty, and sincerity, an individual's character is formed, and we may hope to prove by example that we value character. These are all qualities that our members must possess.
At this point, the induction ceremony will begin. Inductees, please stand and listen for your name to be called. When you hear your name called, walk to the table. Once at the table, sign the National Honor Society logbook, receive your medal, and then be seated. Again, audience members, please hold all applause until the end. Kara Adkins. Ashlyn Allen. Cruz Allison. Elise Banks. Wyatt Benton. Kirsten Bottles. Kerrigan Bowman. Bryce Brown. Savannah Brown. Kaylin Brown. Abigail Campbell. Ava Carpenter. Anna Gross. Andrea Jackson. Aiden Johns. Olivia Jones. Layla Knapp. Titus Kramer. Samantha Lambert. Kira Lewis. Chloe Lucas. Greta Moore. Emma Motley. Caden Neely. Courtney Osborne. Caitlin Ragar. Tanner Riley. Bradley Roy. Riley Sarbeck. Raiden Shotwell. Christopher Talbert. Liliana Tucker. Madison Tussey. Alexia Wells. You may now applause. Will the new members rise and repeat the National Honor Society pledge after me? I pledge myself to uphold.
I pledge myself to uphold.
The high purpose of the National Honor Society.
The high purpose of the National Honor Society.
To which I have been selected.
To which I have been selected.
Striving in every way.
Striving in every way.
To make its ideals.
To make its ideals.
The ideals of my school and my life.
The ideals of my school and my life.
Congratulations and welcome to the National Honor Society. Now Mr. Hodge has a few closing comments.
On behalf of the Carlisle High School chapter of the National Honor Society and my co-advisor, Mrs. Kelly Crow, I would like to thank you all for your attendance today in celebrating the achievements of these future leaders. I would also like to thank our school board members, Superintendent Dr. Vail, our principal, Mr. Huber, Mr. Quentin Hammock, Mrs. Ashley Baker, Mr. Eric Clarkson, Mrs. Heather Allison, our speaker, Dr. Michael Greaser, our faculty council, and all other staff members who have helped make this induction ceremony possible. To our members, as a member of the National Honor Society myself, I encourage you to embrace this position and show why you are deserving of membership to such a prestigious organization. When I'm finished speaking, would current members and new inductees please join us on stage for a group picture? Afterward, current members make sure to sign out at the attendance window, and new inductees sign out at the back doors as you exit. Congratulations on your achievements, and we look forward to seeing what you will accomplish. Thank you.